Good morning, children. Welcome back to the English online class of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. I hope all my dear children are very safe and happy at home. So be at home and be safe. Let's move to our lessons. We already started with the story An Encounter in the Woods, written by E.T. Seaton. This book is, or the story is adapted from his own book titled Wild Animals I Have Known. This is a story about how a mother partridge protect her children from a predator. Here, it's a fox. So the story begins with the mother partridge taking her brood to have a drink at the stream for the first time. There were 12 in brood and they were just a day old. They are not capable of protecting themselves from the enemies. So the mother partridge has to be very alert, vigilant and watchful for the enemies. While they were walking in the woods to have a drink, mother partridge saw a fox coming their way. He was coming far across from a meadow. Meadow is an open field with wild grass. Or it's a grassy land with wild plants or flowers. So when she saw the fox, she immediately ordered her children to hide. And the children obeyed the instructions of their mother instantly. Then the mother partridge flew towards the fox. And they had a chase. The fox tried several times to catch hold of her. But he could not succeed. We stopped the story till there in the last class. Then the chase it continued for 5 minutes. The chase it still he couldn't catch the partridge. And he felt it so strange. How could such an animal, such a powerful or strong animal like him, such a clever animal like him, or he has a larger body than the partridge, how such an animal couldn't catch such a small bird? A small bird like a partridge. He couldn't understand the logic behind that. But he didn't stop trying. He followed her, even though he didn't succeed. Then, after a quarter of a mile's race, quarter means 15 minutes or 1/4. Then, after a quarter of a mile's race, what did the mother partridge do? She flew away from the woods because now she understood that her children are in a safe place because she has taken the fox a long way from the place where her children are hiding. She has leaded or she has diverted his path. Now she knows that her children are very safe. And she flew away from that place. But our fox, he felt so surprised. He didn't understand why this mother partridge is doing like this. But he realized that he was made a fool. That he has made a fool. At first she acted as though she is a lame bird and she is hurt. Now she has no difficulty in any moments. She could fly easily. So he understood that, he realized that he has made a fool. And why mother partridge made him a fool? Because she wanted to protect her babies and she wanted to divert his attention or his path. And this is not the first time she has did this. The fox knew that she has did this before also. So he didn't understand why mother partridge is behaving in such a manner. And he stood there surprised. Meanwhile, our mother partridge, she flew in a great circle and took a different path, which was longer. She didn't flew straight back to the place where her children are hiding. She took a different path to reach her children, to reach where her first balls are. First balls are the words used to describe these baby partridges. First, balls means balls of very soft and fine feather. So she reached the spot where her babies are hiding. Because these birds have excellent memory. As a result, she could reach to the exact spot where her children are hiding. When she reached there, she was so surprised because the children were extremely silent and they were not making any noise. So she called out her babies. Come on, babies, come on. Only when the babies heard their call of their mother, they came out from their hiding place. The baby that lay on the chip means a piece of wood or stone, he came towards the mother and hid under her tail. And all other partridges also joined her. And they were all very happy. So here ends the story. So what's the value that you receive from the story? That mothers are so courageous. Mothers are so brilliant and clever. They know how to protect their babies from any danger they face in life. All the mothers in this world are so courageous and brave to protect the children. They are ready to risk their life and save their children. Whether it be a mother of a bird, an animal, or human beings, all the mothers have the same nature. So, be good children and be obedient. Because whatever the parents convey to us is for our own good. So, obey them and be good children. So, I hope you will all read the text once more and watch the animation video also. Learn the notes that is attached. The animation video of the poem, The Fly, is also attached. Watch that video also. Hope all will learn the notes. That's all for today. Let's wind up the session. See you in the next class.